Today, we're going to replace a hard drive with a 2.5-inch SSD drive in an 8-year-old Asus K53E laptop. This Windows 7 laptop originally came with a 500GB hard drive, but I'd never made the move to an SSD. In this tutorial, I'll be moving to a 240GB SSD, so my use case is to replace a larger drive with a smaller one. But I will touch upon the things you'd need to do if you were going to a larger SSD. As in a previously published video, I'll use Macrium Software's free cloning program to perform the clone. After we clone, the SSD will remain bootable. With the old hard drive still in the laptop, let's first go to Macrium's website to download their free cloning software. First, search for Macrium Reflect Free and click the link to their website. Since my last video on cloning to an M2 SSD, the process for downloading and installing the software has changed slightly. So I'll go ahead and show the procedure. Click the button for home use, which will pop up a dialog to enter your email. Once you do so, click continue. Select whether you want to receive their news and hit continue again. You'll receive an email from Macrium with a link that allows you to download their software. So simply copy and paste that link into the address bar. Go ahead and click save, and once it's been downloaded, locate the file and run it. This is a small stub application that downloads the actual installer. Click the Run button, and then, after confirming you've selected the free version, hit Download to save the installer to the default download location. On the next dialog box, click Next, which copies all the setup files, and then, once the setup wizard starts, hit Next again. Accept the End User License Agreement. Then make sure you have the home version selected. On the next screen, I'll skip the optional registration of the software, and I'll accept the default installation location and shortcut. Finally, hit the Finish button to start the actual installation. Once that completes, I can click the Finish button one last time, which will launch the Macrium Reflect program. Now we need to physically connect the SSD. There are numerous products on the market that'll help you connect your SSD to a USB port, but the two main types of products you'll find are 2.5-inch enclosures, like the one you see here, into which you slide the SSD and then use the USB cable to connect it to the laptop, or these USB to SATA adapters, which just connect to the bare SSD drive without an enclosure. In this video, I'll use an enclosure manufactured by Sabrent. The SSD I'll be using is an older PNY model that's 240GB. You can use any 2.5-inch SSD you want. The main purpose of this video is to simply show you how to upgrade to that SSD. The enclosure that I'm using is a toolless model without the need for any screws or fasteners, so all I need to do is slide the cover open. With the SATA connector aligned with that of the SSD, I'll just slide in the drive and replace the cover until it snaps back on, like this. I'll then take the USB 3 cable and connect it to the side of the enclosure, as shown here. Finally, I'll plug the other end of the cable into one of the USB ports on the laptop. Returning to Windows, let's go to the Start menu and type in diskmgmt.msc to start the disk management application. You can see that it does detect the SSD. There's no need to initialize the disk or create any partitions, as Macrium Reflect will take care of that during the cloning process. So I'll cancel out of this to show you the 500GB hard drive with its two partitions, and scrolling down, the uninitialized 240GB SSD. After we exit out of disk management, you'll see something curious. The SSD isn't showing up in Macrium Reflect. This is a refresh issue because we plugged in the USB enclosure after starting the program. So I'll simply exit and restart it from the Start menu, after which you'll be able to see the 240GB SSD as well as the original hard drive at the top. Let's now click Clone this disk. We can now select the destination disk, which is the SSD. As I mentioned before, there's only two partitions from the Windows 7 installation. You may see other partitions depending on your version of Windows and your laptop. You'll notice that the first partition is very small relative to the second one, as it's only 100MB as opposed to 466GB for the Windows partition. It's hard to tell the relative sizes by just looking at the boxes representing the partitions, as they're obviously not to scale. What you'll want to do is simply drag the boxes down to the destination disk. Being 466 gigabytes, the Windows partition obviously won't fit into the remaining space on the destination, which is 224 gigabytes, but Macrium Reflect will automatically resize the partition to fit the remaining space, shrinking 466 down to 224. Now, if you're going from a smaller hard drive to a larger SSD, you'll want to expand the Windows partitions manually. By clicking Cloned Partition Properties, you'll be able to manually control the size of your partition. In my case, I don't have to worry about this step since Macrium Reflect automatically shrinks the partition to fit. So I'll cancel out of this. Let's click Next, where I can choose to schedule the clone. Since this is a one-time operation, I'll ignore this screen and hit Next. After reviewing the definition of the clone, we can now click Finish, which will prompt you to run the backup now and save the definition. Since we're doing this only once, I'll opt out of saving and then hit OK. Depending on the size and speed of your drives, the cloning process could take quite some time. So I'll take a quick break and I'll be right back. For my configuration, you can see that the clone took about 37 minutes. Let's click OK and then close. Both partitions have been cloned successfully to the new drive. And if we start up File Explorer, you can see that the contents of the drives are the same. We're now prepared to physically swap the hard drive with the SSD, so I'll need to power off the computer. Let's close out of all of our programs, and finally, I'll shut down Windows. With the power off, the first thing I'll do is retrieve the SSD from the enclosure. Let's unplug the USB cable and dismantle the cover to take out the SSD. I'll set the drive aside, as well as the enclosure. Next, let's flip over the laptop. Fortunately, the Asus has an easy access cover that's being held by just two Phillips head screws, so it's relatively painless to access the hard drive. Of course, your mileage may vary depending on your laptop. We can slide the cover right off, which I'll set aside. Here's the memory, and here's the hard drive, which is held in place by four screws. Let's remove them with a screwdriver, and then slide the entire assembly to the right by pulling on this plastic tab. There's a metal chassis that we need to separate from the hard drive, which again is held in place by four screws, so I'll remove those. Let's now extract the hard drive and replace it with the SSD. Now it's just a matter of reversing our steps and screwing everything back in. First, the metal frame, and then sliding the SSD into the SATA port, then attaching the frame to the laptop, and finally sliding the easy access cover back on and reapplying the screws. Make sure to keep your original hard disk in a safe place, since you can always revert to it by plugging it back in. We can now flip the laptop right side up, open it up, and hit the power button. After you boot into Windows, it may ask you to reboot immediately after logging in. Upon that second reboot, let's go ahead and launch Disk Management from the Start menu. We are booting to the 240 GB SSD, as seen in the properties here. Let's close out of this and perform a quick test of the SSD with Crystal CrystalMark. Using the default settings, I'll select All Tests, and we'll take a quick coffee break. We see that we have roughly 420 MB/s read and 311 MB/s write for the sequential tests, and approximately 25 read and 60 write for the other three tests. If we compare the numbers to a test I performed before I swapped out the drives, you can see there's a significant improvement, even when using an older garden variety SSD. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching.